Let's take a look at some one-sided limits graphically. Notice for this first limit, we have the limit as x approaches negative 2 from the negative side of the left side. And for the second limit, we have the limit of x approaches negative 2 from the positive side of the right side of f of x. So it's important when determining limits to pay attention to the notation, because a slight variation means something quite different. Notice for both of these, we are approaching negative 2. So let's go ahead and draw a vertical line at x equals negative 2, so we can see exactly where we're approaching. So here's x equals negative 2. And then for this first limit, we're approaching negative 2 from negative side, which will be from this direction here. And then for the second limit, we're approaching negative 2 from the positive side, or the right side. So we're approaching negative 2 along the function here. So to determine the limit, we want to determine what function value we're approaching as we approach negative 2 from the negative side or left side. And a function value would be the y value we're approaching. So as we get closer and closer to negative 2 from the negative side of the left side, we're approaching this function value right here, which we can see from the graph would be positive 2. So this left-sided limit is equal to positive 2. But notice when approaching negative 2 from the positive side of the right side, we're approaching along here. So now we're approaching this point here, which means we're approaching the function value of negative 1. So the right-sided limit is equal to negative 1. So notice how when we have a piece-defined function, the side in which we're approaching the given value of x makes a big difference. This last limit is a regular limit, which you can think of as a double-sided limit. For this limit to exist, we have to approach negative 2 from both the left and right side, and we must be approaching the same function value. Well, we just showed above that when we approach from the left, the limit is equal to 2, and when we approach from the right, it's equal to negative 1, so we can see we're not approaching the same function value from the left and the right. Therefore, this limit does not exist because we're not approaching the same function value from the left and right. Let's take a look at three more examples. Notice all three of these limits were approaching positive 2, but this first limit is only from the left side or negative side. The second limit is only from the positive side or right side, and the third limit is from both sides of positive 2. So let's go ahead and sketch a vertical line at x equals 2. So for this first one-sided limit, we're approaching positive 2 from the negative or left side. So we're approaching positive 2 in this direction here. For the second limit, we're approaching positive 2 from the positive side or right side. So we're approaching 2 from this side. And then the last limit we're approaching from both sides. So as we approach positive 2 from the left or negative side, notice how we're approaching this point here where the y-coordinate is positive 1, therefore we're approaching the function value of positive 1. This left-sided limit is equal to positive 1. And then notice when we approach along the green arrow from the right side, we're approaching that same point, so we're approaching the same function value of y equals 1. So for this last limit, when x approaches positive 2 from both sides, we can see that since both one-sided limits were the same, the limit as x approaches 2 of f of x would also be equal to positive 1. So notice how, even though this function does not exist at x equals 2, all of the limits did exist, because the idea is what function value we're approaching, not what it's equal to at 2. We'll take a look at some more one-sided limits and limits at infinity in the next video.